Everybody we've got here today, first of all, executive producer Jeffrey Bell. Executive producer Scott Peters. I think you may be a little familiar with our next guest, Elizabeth Mitchell. The best ass kicking in there so far. Morris Chestnut. Next up, a gentleman who you guys have seen around here in years past, Mr. Joel Gretsch. Somebody hopefully very nice, don't be too scared, Marina Backer in playing. A person may be familiar with a guy named Scott Wolf. Next, Steve Perlman. I can, so if you haven't ready, we're going to do a little quick thing here. We're going to get to your questions, so get ready. I guess the first thing I'll throw out to you guys, producers and actors both, why me and why now? I know it's source material, one way to go. Again, we got to return to this one and do it differently this time.
Well, you know, V is an unbelievably iconic, cool story from, you know, 25 years ago, and it obviously people are still super excited about it. You know, a lot has happened in 25 years, you know, in a post 9/11 world, there's a lot of paranoia. There's a lot of stuff in the news that, a lot of bad things. It's really tough to kind of get our heads around it. Sometimes the economy is tanked, and every time you turn on the news, it seems to get worse and worse. And it just seemed like an interesting time to try and bring about something or some entity that would maybe help save us. It's kind of an interesting concept to think that, wow, wouldn't it be great if 29 ships showed up and all these beautiful people said, hey, we're going to take care of all your problems. Not so much.
Today, I assume the script was written fairly recently. I mean, everything seems so topical within the script.
The healthcare thing, this has come up pretty quickly, but yes.
So you'll be hearing from the White House a little bit later. As you know, one quick thing, Scott, I just had a question for you. Which would you say is scarier, a cable news reporter or an alien? Or maybe it's a toss-up.
It's a tie, but I think there's something beautifully creepy about what Marina brought to the head of the aliens, wasn't there?
For you guys as actors, were you familiar with, you know, the original material? Did you like watch it before you went back to watch it once you got the parts?
Totally into the original V. I used to watch it with my brother and totally creeped out by the peeling faces, the lizard skin, I mean all of it. I thought it was genius.
Did you guys watch it growing up?
I did watch it. I had huge memories of the alien baby. And I liked all the chases with the you know, what would you call them, a hovercraft? Like what do you call them? Space shuttle. I enjoyed watching the space shuttle races because I like that kind of stuff. I think it's cool when things don't have wheels or jets. I just like it.
Oh, that's very good. How about the rat eating too? Anybody? I know we talked rat eating yesterday. Ready to eat a rat?
Yeah, I believe it was a gigantic gerbil. The original. I'm gonna rely on my wonderful producers to not make me put furry things in my mouth. But we'll see. I got fun.
Good one.
Leave it alone, don't go there.
They just got a couple ideas for season 3 right there. So. All right, well, I know we want to make sure we get to everybody's questions, so I want to get going and get with the questions now.
Hi, my name is Marco from VFans.com, and I wanted to ask, as the writers, how do you, or what are some of the difficulties of writing a new show and staying true to the original at the same time?
There's a lot of choices to make. What we didn't want to do is just mimic the original. We also wanted to pay homage to it and honor it and not step all over it. I think that as I said earlier, it's a terrific, wonderful, iconic piece of entertainment, and it worked beautifully in the time that it was presented. There were a lot, as I said before, the world was a much different place, and the themes were much different that would resonate with audiences back then. And so the trick was to try and find our own voice, and not stepping on the old characters, not stepping on the old themes, but sort of bringing it forward and really looking to have it resonate with audiences today, with what's going on in the world. As well as introduce you to a whole new sort of group of wonderful ensemble cast of characters, so that you can sort of really see how this gigantic event was affected, how it affected all of these people and all their individual stories.
Jace, this question's for you. You've got several successful online properties like the Jace Hall Show. I wanted to know if you're using any of the lessons that you've learned from delivery of online content for V. Like, are we going to see different ways to download V, not paying $4 in iTunes for an HD?
Is this on?
Okay.
Hey. Having spent a lot of time in online, we certainly, as a group, see the opportunities that exist for the way to communicate the story or parts of it or things associated with the story in new mediums. So, rest assured that we absolutely are thinking about it, and that, talking with Scott and with Jeff about this and the studios, everybody's very supportive of it. And I think it's a very good way to keep everybody engaged and create some additional depth to the great TV series that we're building here today. So, yeah.
We only have time for one more question.
And please, feel free to ask anything.
Hi there. You ladies are beautiful. My question is, with the reimagining of Battlestar Galactica being so hugely popular and well done, how has that made this show easier to bring to audiences?
One of our biggest challenges, well, Battlestar Galactica is awesome. And so we're intimidated by its success. And one of the things that we need to do a little differently, because they're on the Sci-Fi Channel and we're on ABC, is to put some of our emphasis in a different place. And so, they're a military show, we're not a military show. Because of how we're built, we're focusing a lot more on character drama, relationships set against this giant thing. We think there's something really cool about showing really ordinary people of all race, colors, and creeds to come together. And to ask the question, what do you do when you come face to face with something amazing, something, Anna's face on the giant ship and the promise of something really great. And so, rather than going to war or running away, we think it's really interesting to see, what does a businessman or a newscaster or a mom or a couple do in this situation. And so our focus is more on that. But we are humbled and very aware of Battlestar and the high bar that it set.
All right. Thank you guys. I apologize for the brevity of it. You're going to see a great show, all right? Thank you guys. It's really a show. We're really proud of the work. It's really, really good. When do you think people here might be able to watch the series?
You're good at
yes. Season?
Show people.
It's before November.